You're here at Monterey Bay Seaweeds. We are a land-based farm on the coast of California, right here in Monterey Bay. We produce fresh, raw, and alive seaweed for the culinary markets in the United States. Anywhere in the continental US, we will ship you fresh, raw, and live seaweed. This is all done in what we consider to be the most sustainable practices possible. We don't use any chemicals. We use natural sunlight, we use naturally fertilized seawater, and a whole bunch of labor to really try to make the highest quality seaweed possible to get it in front of people on their plate. We're really excited to be here. There's a lot of projects on site here, but what you're gonna see today is probably about 5 or 6 years worth of starting with anecdotal to then scientific to now really hardcore industry R&D on how to produce seaweeds on land in a way that is economically feasible and really as sustainable as possible. And I think get a better appreciation of what it takes to create, you know, really high quality seaweed on the coast of California. We're actually at a facility owned by the Cal State University at Moss Landing Marine Labs. It's a public-private partnership where we as a private company can come onto public lands and work our production systems in partnership with the universities. We're at the CSU, we like to have students get fully integrated. I mean, look, you're outside here just a quarter mile away from the main laboratory where you get to take all your classes, and you've got your hands in everything. It could be oceanography, it could be chemistry, it could be physics, it could be engineering, or it could be any type of organisms here. Plus you get to integrate it into climate, you get to integrate into natural systems, into fisheries, you can scuba dive, you can be on the mud flat. It really is a great spot if you want to have that intensive hands-on experience that's really well-rounded. So for me, sustainability has lots of levels. It's taking things that might be unsustainable and making them more sustainable, or just starting with inherently sustainable systems. Those are systems where I feel we don't have to put an enormous amount of energy to keep them going. So we are not using resources to keep these systems going. So a lot of times they're using natural resources, natural sunlight. Maybe they're using nutrient waste streams from another product so that we don't have to feed those products. Or maybe they're harvested in ways that are environmentally sustainable that might be energy saving. And so together they just kind of bring a less intrusive and energy intensive way of producing food.